Welcome, everyone. Welcome to the Mary Jane Mack Show on Transformation Talk Radio. I'm your co-host, Nancy, and I'm here with Mary Jane and the as wonderful Benny. Benny's here.
Hello, ladies. Welcome back. Good to see you again.
It's good to be back. For those of you who are new to the Mary Jane Mack Show, Mary Jane is a holistic intuitive. She has an office in Issaquah, Washington, and it's been there since 1992. She does the TAP system, the accelerated performance system. She muscle tests your body, figures out what's going on, recommends a whole food nutrition product that gets in your body, balances you out, and brings you back to your optimal health. How's that, Mary Jane?
Oh, that's really good, Nancy.
It's probably the best one you've done.
Thank you very much.
I'm just going to copy and paste it so then you don't have to
please, that would be great. That would be great. I know I'm always getting, you know, Benny's always giving me
useful information.
Yeah, exactly. So I appreciate
that.
She
just has to remember it.
Yeah, so if you could just, that would be great.
That's beyond me, right?
So next month when we're here, you're just going to hear that same introduction, right. And then I'll just come in and start talking. Okay, we have a great show today. Just to let you know ahead of time, Mary Jane, we'll be taking your phone calls. So if you have a ongoing health issue that you just can't get figured out, or you have a child who's experiencing extreme fatigue with all those sports. I know by my house, you can hear the sports games going on till like 9:30 or 10 o'clock at night, which is mind-boggling. Soccer, baseball, or what's the
baseball?
Ball? No, it's baseball. What's the ball? It's not cricket. It's
pickleball,
no.
Badminton.
Oh God, lacrosse.
Lacrosse. Oh, there you go. Okay.
Yeah.
You were waving like multiple.
I'm waving a stick.
It's like batting a ball.
Right. Yeah. Multiple sports then pop into my head when you have a utility.
I know. I'm so sorry. My cousin plays lacrosse, and he's an excellent lacrosse player. So I've seen him out practicing doing that lacrosse. So if you have a child who's fatigued or even a pet, if you have a pet who's got itching, constant itching.
Anything.
Or even parents that attend those games.
Exactly.
Bingo. They're up and against the, you know.
Yeah, working all day.
Stressful times too, yeah.
Working all day, yeah. Sitting in the stands, trying to be supportive of that child, saying to yourself, why did I put them in this sport?
But not overly aggressive.
Correct.
Very supportive. We want that to be known.
Yes, we want supportive parents, not competitive parents.
Right.
So if you have a question for Mary Jane, go ahead and give us a call at 1-800-930-2819. She can tackle any question. You'll be amazed.
I see what you did there. That was cute.
What?
Tackle sports.
Oh, you got
you
it?
Didn't even know.
Look at you.
You're so
no,
cute.
I'm really I'm a huge, huge cute. Hockey fan. So I've been like watching all the hockey.
Playoffs. Oh, she is a hockey fan.
Oh, whoa. I love hockey. So anyway, okay, enough about sports. Mary Jane, today we're talking about the checklist of health issues, but today we're going to integrate some emotions into that once again.
Right. Well, last time we talked about the checklist for health issues, and today I absolutely thought we'd talk about the emotions connected to that. When I see people every day and they come in, and they might come in with the same thing each time. For example, my little toe is swollen and hurts me. And It just doesn't get better. It's not getting better. And we might work on it and get it all lined up and feeling good. And as the person leaves and things start happening again, that toe gets swollen. So my question would be, well, what's going on in your life? What's happening? Because when you have recurrent issues, especially little annoying things that pop up all the time, or they could be big annoying things, it's a red flag to look at things deeper. And everything that happens in your body has an emotional, you store an emotion in that organ or joint or area. And so you look at what is the emotion that's causing that to flare up, that your body is just asking you to look at it so you could solve the mystery. It's your journey to work through these challenges and step into your power by figuring out how you could be better or what is it and letting go. The biggest, the best words I could tell the people is when things pop in and you have people in your lives, challenges in your lives with family, it's about allowing that issue to, allowing it to come through and letting go. The more you hang on to it and take
try
it
and
in,
fix it.
Then the more, the more you try and fix it and take care of it, the stronger your own emotional issues will become. And remember, you can't fix anybody's problems. The only one you could take care of yourself. So again, there are so many different situations that we could talk about today. And I'm sure that you have those same things in your life that I just want to bring it to bring it up so you could look at things differently. And another example would be someone coming in saying, I'm here because I want to prevent cancer. My father died of cancer and my mother died of cancer. And my mother was very health conscious. She did everything right. She was all her life. She just was just a health practiced good health and good nutrition. And so once my mother died and she did all those good things, she said, I didn't care anymore. I figured if that didn't work for her, why should I keep doing that? And then I start doing what I wanted to do. So when you look at people who've done all the right things and they still get cancer and still have other issues or diseases, it's what's really going on in their life. What happened? What happened? It's usually 5-7 years before somebody gets cancer that something happened, an emotion they took in that they never healed from. Then that festers, you might say, and that's how they create cancer.
And we brought along our handy-dandy guide today. It's a book by Louise Hay, You Can Heal Your Life. And in the book, it has all kinds of health issues. And under cancer, it says it's a deep hurt, long-standing resentment. Who doesn't have that? Deep secret or grief eating away at the self. Carrying hatreds. What's the use? So then what you want to replace that with, I lovingly forgive and release all of the past. I choose to fill my world with joy. I love and approve of myself. So the deep hurt, the deep resentment, you have to take a look. What is that?
Well, the other thing is recognizing where it's coming from, because you could go to the doctor and they could say, your cancer, for example, is from smoking, or your specifically. Or your cancer is from the way you neglecting your body. And, that could be true, but the real foundation is what's really going on in your life that you never dealt with and you were so hurt and angry or unable to get through that it just festered inside of you and then you created and set up your body to get this cancer. And when I ask people, when people come in and I ask, well, what happened 5 years before or 7 years before, they can always come up with something. And it's either somebody died or they got a divorce. Usually women who wind up with breast cancer, it's their husband. Often it's their husband's had an affair. They wind up getting divorced, and because of that hurt and emotion and not getting over it, then they created the cancer. And most of the time, people don't realize that this is emotionally based or how much those emotions, when you trap them in your body, affect you. And through the years, that's how you create major disease. As Nancy said, it's dis-ease.
What are you not at ease with? All right, time for us to take a short break. You are listening to the Mary Jane Mack Show on Transformation Talk Radio. We'll catch you on the other side.
Staring at two different views on your window. Coffee is gone cold, it's
Discover the 8 things the elements of prosperity want you to know. Lynn Brown is hosting a life-transforming, soul-expanding evening on April 30th featuring guest speaker and radio host Dr. Pat Basile. Lynn was guided to make this a by-donation event for entrance, and all proceeds will be donated towards uplifting the homeless community. For more information and to get tickets, visit eventbrite.com. That's eventbrite.com and type Lynn Brown in the search.
On the cutting edge of the new mainstream, Christine Upchurch is passionate about bringing together science, psychology, and spirituality in a way that can be applied to our everyday lives for true transformation. The Christine Upchurch Show. Stellar conversations to illuminate your journey. Engages some of the most outstanding visionaries on the planet in lively dialogue to inspire you to become that bright light you're meant to be. Join Christine every Friday at 11 a.m. Pacific Time on KKNW, AM 1150, and Transformation Talk Radio.
Chris Stainis is a spiritual leader and healer and teaches a course on how you can transform your life through a meditation and healing system that will manifest your spirit's dreams. She manifested the Women of Wisdom Conference, the Women of Wisdom book, and this radio show. And she can show you how to change your life too. Are you ready? Visit the website and contact her at voicesofwomentoday.com. That's voicesofwomentoday.com.
There are so many resources out there for meditation, but did you know that Atana's Heart Earth Healing Meditation is available for you for free? Yes, that's right. You can receive this free healing meditation today from Atana Badili. All you need to do is visit his website, atanamethod.com. That's A-T-A-A-N-A method.com, and sign up. You will receive your free meditation instantly. That's atanamethod.com.
Hey, everybody, this is Dr. Pat. Many of you have heard me talk about the Lyme disease epidemic going on right now in the world. I want to tell you about my friends at Results RNA. They have now created an entire Lyme support system for immune system support, detoxification, rejuvenation, and neurological healing. Please visit ResultsRNA.com to learn more. And for first-time orders, you'll receive a special 10% discount. All you have to do is type in Dr. Pat at checkout.
Francine Vale is a being of light. She believes that all people of planet Earth are as well. As co-host of the Angel Healer radio show, Francine teaches you heart-centered ways to manifest healing on your own behalf and how to integrate love more fully into your daily life. Connect with your angels as you find your life flowing with ease and harmony. Walk the path of light with Francine and Dr. Pat Basile every month on TransformationTalkRadio.com.
Coffee is gone cold, it's like time froze. There you go, wishing, floating down, I'm wishing. It's like I'm always causing problems.
Welcome back. You're listening to the Mary Jane Mack Show on Transformation Talk Radio. I'm your co-host, Nancy, and I'm here with Mary Jane. And today we're going through the checklist of health issues and the emotions that are related to those health issues. So, Mary Jane, where would you like to go now?
Well, we could start with lungs. Let's start with the lungs. Lungs are grief.
Do you want me to find lungs in our magic book?
Well, you can. That would be great. This is a great handy book. And there's another book, Feelings Buried Alive Never Die. So the whole idea is whenever you take in an emotion, whether it's real or not real, that emotion is stored in an organ in your body. And as you experience that very same emotion over and over again, it's when the energy gets so full that you no longer can tolerate it that you start creating symptoms. And that's your body's way of not only taking care of the physical, but looking at what's really going on with you so your body can heal and you can move on to a higher vibration.
Well, according to Louise, the lung is the ability to take in life, or if you've got pneumonia or depression, grief, fear of taking in life, not feeling worthy of living life fully. So those are her two. So we always say it's grief.
Well, it's grief and it's
fear, depression.
It's mostly like I look at it as grief and something like grief over losing someone, grief over losing a job. It could be grief over anything. And it's how you take it in. Those people might have trouble breathing. They might have chronic lung conditions. That's where they see. It's like that's where all their issues are, and that's because their body needs to look at what's really going on. And if you keep treating the physical, you never really get to the solution.
Well, because it keeps coming back. Right?
Exactly.
It never goes away. It may get better, but it never goes away.
Exactly. And usually you're on medication, you're on treatments, you're on, it's like asthma, you know, you're always on something to treat that until you figure out what's really going on. And it could be something that happened early in life. And remember that you can store an emotion in the womb. So from the first time of conception through the rest of your life, you can take in emotions. For example, when in the womb, if your parents didn't want to have you, if you were not wanted and your parents were upset and there were a lot of issues over that, you could take on that emotion and be born with that and then struggle with that for many, many years. But there's ways of muscle testing to figure out where the emotion came from. Like when I can check someone, I just check when was the time. And I do conception to birth, birth to 10. And you could figure out the exact age and then the timing of what the organ is. So then you know what it is. And that gives, then there's other techniques to help you clear it. And it's often just the awareness of what it is that allows you to heal and let go.
And start to process it to let go.
Exactly. It's recognizing that it's even there. And once we figure this out, it always makes so much sense to each person, to the individual, that they just never looked at it that way. And it gives them a whole new way of approaching it and being able to heal their body into wellness.
And move forward.
Exactly. It actually is so much fun. It really is.
Oh, it's so much fun as long as you're not that person. No.
Well, it's even fun for that person. When we do this process and we talk about what, you know, they come in with one problem, then we talk about an issue, but you got to talk about what's really going on here. And once you kind of ask questions and figure out what's happening with the family or with the parents or kids or whatever, and it's like the light bulb goes on, and then they said, oh my gosh, that makes so much sense. And they can put the pieces together and then step forward into that healing process.
So it's quick. It can be quick, easy, and not painful at all.
Yeah, it's more painful when you're resisting. So if you're resisting and you want to, you know, you're not willing to let go, you're happy to stay in that, you think you're in control, you think you can fix it, that things just get worse. And you keep going around in the same circles. Because it's always about letting go and not being attached to the outcome.
And not trying to control it.
Exactly. Because if you're attached to the outcome and you think you have to be right and you have all the answers, well, then you're in trouble, because nobody has all the answers. And Wayne Dyer always said, you don't have to be a right fighter. If you're a right fighter, you're in trouble.
Yeah, you're always wrong if you're a right fighter. If you have a question for Mary Jane, give us a call at 1-800-930-2819. Okay, where are we going now?
Well, if you have heart issues, anybody that has heart issues, heart...
palpitations?
It could be heart palpitations, things that affect the heart. There's other organs that can affect the heart. But heart is sadness. So sadness can be loss of your parents, loss of a friend, loss of a dog. Sadness could be loss of a relationship. It could be something that you heard that you thought was true. Like, has somebody ever told you something like, Nancy, Rebecca said that you're really a flaky person and not very nice. And so you hear that, and that's how you take it in and think, well, why would she think that? And now you think people are talking about you. So you've taken that emotion, and it may not even be true.
Well, thank you for using me as an example. A flaky person. Wow.
That's exactly what happens. That's how you take in that emotion. That was a very good example, Nancy.
Well, that's my job here, Mary Jane. That's my job.
You take it in. It wasn't real, even if somebody talks about that. And it's how deep you take it in that affects you.
Even if you were to say, even if a person was to say, well, I really don't care what Rebecca thinks about me, but there is a part of you that actually does.
Yes.
There is. And so you may have that. Well,
then it's spinning in your head.
Yeah. So then it's going to keep popping up, even though you're like, she's a flake anyway. What does she know? But you know that it's already there.
Yeah.
It's there. So now the process starts. Yeah.
So the sadness in the heart, that's people who could have heart trouble, who could have need heart surgery, who have more major heart issues. They have blockages. So you look at what happened either when they were younger, but you often it's like 5 to 7 years before. And then you want to clear those things so that they don't continue having heart issues. And so they're able to heal and get through that.
All right. Heart was good.
Yeah.
I liked heart. I think we're going to have to clear that emotional component, that flakiness after the show.
Well, then you go to liver. Liver's always anger. Liver's anger. And gallbladder's resentment. So when you have things going on your liver and with your gallbladder, it could affect all your organs. So that's like really a big red flag. What are you resenting? What could be resenting your family doesn't really care about you, resenting that your family doesn't do what you want them to do, resenting that you're not where you are in your job, you hate your job, you resent your boss. So it goes on, and until you look at that and really figure it out, you're not going to go any further in that job. You're going to stay where you are. The universe has a way of pushing you to figure out your issues so that you can move through it. And if you don't figure it out, you have to keep repeating it over and over again.
Well, it just gets louder.
Yeah.
The universe cycle kind of give you a little nudge, and you're like, that's interesting. And then, you know, it could be 6 months later or 3 months later, you get another little nudge, and those nudges become louder and louder until maybe one day you fall and break your leg or
exactly.
Get into a fender bender. Yeah. Or it's so like if you're going to keep resisting, well, we're going to show you that this needs to come to light and get it taken care of.
It's like, oh, I tripped and I fell over a curb. Then I tripped and I fell over a bucket. And you hear that. And then it's like, well, wait a minute here. You got to stop and look at what this is really about. Oh, they're thinking I'm so clumsy. I just did that. No, the universe is trying to talk to you and figure things out before you do fall and break your leg.
So you have to, again, it's that stop and listen, pay attention. We all have that sixth sense. You know, you have that gut feeling that you get. Sometimes you're like, well, I know what my gut's telling me, but I'm going to go and do this anyway. And how many times does that usually backfire on you?
Well, it's like car accidents, fender benders. When people have fender benders, you hear people, I've had five rear ends. People have rear-ended me 5 times. What are you not getting you have to be shaken up, and then you're just thinking you're the victim, and it's, you know, why are people doing this to me instead of, like, trying to figure out why is this happening? Car accidents have something to do with what's going on in your life, of course, and so you look at where are you stuck in your life and not moving.
When we bring those emotions in, it is just huge. But it's fun. According to Mary Jane, it's always fun.
It's fun that you look at it different. Instead of looking at it, I have a gallbladder issue, or I have a bladder issue, or you know what it is. Yeah, you have those things, but why are you getting it? And you might be better, and then later it comes back again. Well, it's because you still haven't really totally gotten rid of it.
So.
And again, that could be anything. It could be family. It could be an old divorce. It could be bitterness over and angry over a relationship.
It could be anything. Emotions can be anything. And it all depends on how we take those in. So, okay. Well, when we come back, we're going to be talking about some more emotions and making everybody aware of really what's going on. You are listening to the Mary Jane Mack Show on Transformation Talk Radio.
Sky Siegel co-hosts one of today's most popular psychic shows, Angels and Answers, with Artie Hoffman as she communicates healing messages from the spirit world. These messages can be astounding, enlightening, and life-changing. Born with the God-given talent of inner guidance and the amazing ability to heal, Sky has healed thousands of people. Schedule a reading with Sky now. Call 908-500-1474 and visit skyofangels.com.
Do you want to achieve your goals? Do you want to strengthen relationships with others? Do you want to improve your financial status? Colette Marie Steffen is partnering with Mark Kettenbach to bring you an energetic upgrade online experience launching in April. Unfold and develop your full potential. Visit energeticupgrade.com today for more information. That's energeticupgrade.com.
Put a little in your life with Keys. Keys Clear Protein Waters have 22 grams of smile-making, attitude-adjusting protein in every bottle. Did I mention its tongue-tingling taste? Not just another guilty pleasure. With Keys, you'll enjoy every low-sugar sip and freedom from gluten, lactose, and GMOs. Who needs the fountain of youth when you can find Keys on Amazon or at Keys, K-E-E-S, please.com. Put a little woohoo in your attitude with Keys Protein Water.
How would you like increased health and vitality? How would you like to avoid the onset of disease as well as slow the aging process? This is all possible through a simple, safe, and natural process. Every day, we are either moving toward wellness or away from wellness.
Hi, I'm Mary Jane Mack. I'd like to be your partner in achieving optimal health. Contact me now at MaryJaneMack.com or call 425-392-0659. Visit MaryJaneMack.com.
Hey, Owen, I just heard about this book on the Dr. Pat Show, and these reviews on Amazon are amazing.
Oh, yeah? What's the book?
It's called Conscious Being by T.J. Woodward.
Oh, he's the Awakened Living radio host.
Yeah. This book looks like just the guide we've been looking for to really connect and make those conscious changes in our everyday relationships and experiences.
I love it. Can we get it on our Kindle apps?
Of course.
To learn more about Conscious Being and author T.J. Woodward, visit ConsciousBeingBook.com.
Do you want the freedom to spend more time with your loved ones? Travel the world? Live spontaneously? Get ready, because the Chip Justice Show is here. Hosts Dr. Pat Basile and Chip Justice can help you build meaningful success while embracing life. Living a life you love is the end game in this new, inspirational, and empowering show. Positive changes for a life you'll love. Tune in every month on TransformationTalkRadio.com and visit PositiveChangeInstitute.co for more information.
Welcome back, everyone.
I was working my inner Rihanna.
Yeah, you were. Yeah, we're having a little giggle session because we're chair dancing here. You are listening to the Mary Jane Mack Show on Transformation Talk Radio. I'm your co-host, Nancy. I'm here with Mary Jane, who is a holistic intuitive. And I'm here with Benny, who's in charge of all of our music and all of those crazy buttons.
I do what I can. Thank you.
You do an amazing job.
Thank you.
We love you.
Love you, too.
Okay. All right. We're talking about the checklist. We're talking about emotions. I'm going to give out Mary Jane's office number, and that number is 888-777-4232. If you would like to have an appointment with Mary Jane, give the office a call at 888-777-4232. She not only sees people in her office, but she does phone consultations. I've been popping in and out of the office every once in a while, and people... I've been lucky enough to meet some of our listeners who have come in to see Mary Jane, which has always been fun. They recognize my voice, which I think is a little scary, but because when I listen to myself on the radio, I'm not a big fan of my voice. But so it's always a lot of fun. So if you want to have an appointment with Mary Jane, give her office a call. Get those health issues taken care of and get your emotions starting to clear out. If you have a question, go ahead and give us a call here at 1-800-930-2819. Okay, we've done.
We get the lungs, we did the heart, we did the liver, the gallbladder.
Now what are we doing? Where are we going?
Where are we going?
Where are we going?
The bladder is being ticked off. Part of that is fear. Kidney and bladder are kind of connected. Anxiety, holding on to old beliefs. So, again, if you're having chronic bladder infections, bladder issues, what's going on in your life? What's causing, and especially if it's not going away, then what you've really got to start looking at the emotion instead of jumping from doctor to doctor to doctor to try and figure it out, you have the answer. So go a little deeper and look back on what is going on in your life. And once you recognize it, you can, there are many things you could do to help get rid of it. There's the emotional freedom technique, the tapping solution, that you could read about on online. There's lots of information on Dr. Mercola's site on that. And it's something you could do at home. But again, just recognizing what it is can help you get rid of it. And then if you're still having issues, there's a lot of places where you could get help.
Well, the other thing is, if they come into the office, you can not only tap into the actual emotion, but then you can also give the nutritional support that they need.
Absolutely. We deal with that every day.
Because so it's a package thing.
It's a package. When you come to me, it's not just about physical, what's going on. It's the whole package. It's what's going on with you emotionally. Where are you in your life? Where do you want to go? What's keeping you from getting there? I mean, I deal with all types of executives from like Microsoft, people who are in pretty good high positions, and they're looking for, they're on the same journey. It's like, and they'll come into a wall and think, oh, this job isn't for me. I want to leave. I can't do this. And when we test, it's absolutely where they're supposed to be. They need to hang in there, and your body has all the answers. All I do is tap into your body. And there will be a solution, but it's something that they have to work through, like the situation at work, to get to the other side, to be at a higher vibration and be in a better place. When the universe pushes you in a direction, it's always for your
highest
best.
Good.
Yes.
It's always for your highest good. Even though we can sometimes resist. That's not really where I want to go. I want to do this. But we really don't know, but the universe knows.
Exactly. And if you're getting pushed out of a job or that you think you
love,
you apply for a job and you don't get it, well, then you just look at it and say, isn't that interesting? And know that there is something better. And when you have that and don't get bitter and angry, then the universe will show it to you faster. If you're bitter and angry, then you have to go through more tests, more challenges. So try and get it as quickly as you can, because if you don't, you're going to have to keep doing it over and over again.
Yeah, over and over.
And so getting a job, that's a good way to look at it. Getting a job, buying a house. When things don't work out, it's for your good usually. So you look at, just look at it as, isn't that interesting? And know that there's something better to come.
Oh, yeah, because I think buying a house, having that emotional attachment when you walk in and go, oh, this is perfect. I love it. I can see myself here. And then having it all fall apart, you're kind of like heartbroken. But
there's usually something wrong with the house, or the universe has something even better for you.
So instead of looking at it as a negative, view it as a positive. You can still be sad. But then always know that there's something better on the other side.
Yeah. And when you have that attitude, it comes to you faster. And I see it all the time with these people with challenges in their jobs and then looking for a job and wanting a job and wanting to change. They're in a high-pressure situation, and they want to change. And it's about putting it out there, putting out what you want and not settling. You keep going. And when you put it out there and you make a list of what do you want, what kind of money do you want, what abundance do you want, what is it? And you write it down and you're clear. I get calls from people that we've worked with and done this with. They've got their ideal job. They got everything they want. They got all the money they wanted. And they're just, because they hung in there and they knew, they started to trust they could do it. And exactly. It was a challenge, but they got there.
Well, that goes back to one of our previous shows, your I am statements, too. You get what you think about. So if you're always thinking about what you want, it's going to come to you. But if you think about what you don't have and, you know, focus on all the negative, well, I'm still stuck. I'm still this. That's where you're going to stay.
Exactly. And this is what I deal with when people come into me. It's not just about the physical. It's about the emotional. It's about where are you in your life? Where are you going? And we can muscle test all those things to help them be clearer on what direction they're going. Because, again, the body has all the answers. All we do is tap into your energy.
So remember, your kids could have emotional components. Even your pets can have an emotional component. So nobody's special. We all have them. We're all lucky enough to have them. And if we're all lucky enough to have somebody help us find exactly what they are so that we can start to let go. Let go and believe and trust.
And know that when somebody is working through an emotion or your kids are working through the emotion, it's not to rush them through it. It's to understand when kids are kind of testy and everything, not to totally squelch them down, but to listen to them and know that they're in a process, too, that they have to work through and guide them and to be there.
Be patient.
To hear.
Okay. So we did bladder. We did lungs. We did liver. What's thyroid?
Thyroid is past emotions.
Okay, so let me. Thyroid, past emotions. That's kind of a.
Thyroid is what's happened to you in the past that you're stuck on and can't get let go of. It's old issues. It's like could be from your family when you were a kid. Could be from something that happened 6 years ago, 10 years ago. It's you're dwelling in the past and being stuck there. And can't move forward. So it's about looking at what's going. Again, with muscle testing, we can test exactly what it is.
And I think that's interesting because in your office, everybody seems to be totally surprised that when you say it happened 4 years ago, this time.
We could say 4 years ago, you could figure out the month, January or February. And they, when you do that, it pops in. They know exactly what it was.
Right.
And if they don't know at that moment, they walk away and think about it, and they come back and say, yes, I do know exactly what it was.
Yeah. Or something will happen. Well, it's, yeah. I'm kind of confused here. Well, I'm at a loss for words now. I'm at a loss.
But again, it's recognizing what it is so that you could heal your body and move forward. It's any type of, you have organs like inflammation, even thyroid disease, other stronger issues, Hashimoto's and viruses in your thyroid. It's where do those come from? And why did you have to create that to become big to look at what's going on with you?
Yeah, or people who think things are hereditary.
Well, you're born with it, things. If your mother had it, your father had it, your brothers had it, my five brothers died of this, and all the. Well, you're born with your parents' nutritional deficiencies.
And emotional.
And if your parents both had issues or had cancer, when you're born, and they never corrected those issues, when you're born, you could have that tendency toward the same thing. So it's like, if however, if you're born with those things and you are more aware and become take care of your emotions and also your physical, you get on a nutritional path and take different care of your body. You could change that. That doesn't mean you're stuck with that because your parents had it, your brothers had it. You have the ability to change that at any time.
We all have.
But if you're stuck in, oh, they had it, now I'm going to get it, well, you're creating that. It's you're drawing it to you. So it's about knowing that you're an individual. You do not have to have that. You do have to deal with your physical and emotional body and spiritual body. And that will take you on a path to change it for your children.
Yeah.
So your kids don't have to be born with the same issues.
Again, the body has the ability to heal itself. We just have to find the person to help us get in there, tap into the emotions, get on the right nutrition protocol, and amazing things can happen. And it's lucky for you that we have Mary Jean to do that for us. Okay, it's time for us to take another short break. You are listening to the Mary Jane Mack Show on Transformation Talk Radio. Catch you on the other side.
I took a pill in Ibiza to show Avicii I was cool. And when I finally got sober, felt 10 years older, but it was something to do. I'm living out in L.A. I drive a sports car just to prove I'm a real big
The doctor is in. Tune in to the hit show, The Psychic Love Doctor, with host Deborah Lee. Deborah's life-affirming, highly perceptive reading method has taught Deborah how to zero in on specific problems with relationships, career pursuits, and current roadblocks to success and happiness. Join Deborah Fridays at 2 p.m. Pacific and for a special broadcast the second Thursday of every month at 11 a.m. Pacific on TransformationTalkRadio.com.
Hi everyone, this is Dr. Pat. The ancient Inca root vegetable maca is world-renowned for its wide array of health benefits. As a family-run company of true maca specialists, the maca team's mission is to provide you with fresh, organic, premium-quality maca powders at a fair price. Amazing. All of the products are always organically grown, fair-traded, GMO-free, fresh, and potent. So don't take my word for it. Experience the life-changing benefits of maca today. Visit themacateam.com.
Are you searching? Looking for a sign? A message you need to hear? From the great unknown? From the most mysterious place that is the most familiar to your soul and the depths of who you are? The universe put someone here to talk to. Someone God gave a blessing to that you may find insight with. TheAngelLady.net. 1-800-323-1790.
Have you ever tried to make lifestyle changes but had difficulty following through? Imagine what it would be like to get up each morning with energy, clarity, and motivation to tackle the day. If you want to get past limiting barriers that are preventing you from living your best life, join holistic health and wellness coach T. Carrie Mitchell each month on The Dr. Pat Show. Or visit lifestyle120.com today and start to receive the personal attention you deserve.
Tune in to Sheer Alchemy with Leslie Fontaine on TransformationTalkRadio.com and get ready to stir up your passions, remove your blocks, and shift into an entirely new existence. Speaker, teacher, channel, clairvoyant, Leslie Fontaine is a transformation catalyst who channels a powerful energy from Source to catapult listeners into living the life they were born to live. Whether it's shifting from scarcity to abundance, from emotional pain into joy, or from illness into health, Leslie will help you step into the true essence and power of all that you are with the help of the Ascended Masters and Archangels. You will not be the same. Visit TransformationTalkRadio.com for show dates and times and LeslieFontaine.com to say yes to explosive abundance.
Never really know why it might be. You don't ever want to step off that roller coaster and be all alone. And you don't want to ride the bus like this. Never know who to trust like this. You don't want to be stuck up on that stage. Stuck up on that stage singing. Oh, I know. Sad souls. Sad souls. Darling, oh.
Welcome back, everyone. You're listening to the Mary Jane Mack Show on Transformation Talk Radio. I'm your co-host, Nancy. I'm here with Mary Jane and Benny. And today we are talking about going through the checklist of health issues and the emotions that are attached to those. So during the break, I asked Mary Jane, I said, where we go next? And we decided eyes. Did we say eyes?
Well, I see a lot of people with eye conditions lately. I mean, there's a lot of eye issues. So eyes are not seeing, you know,
like,
like macular degeneration, detached retinas, holes in the macula. I mean, there are so many things, glaucoma, eye irritations, vision, you know, bleeding in the eye. And it's pretty common. It's kind of interesting what people are going through energetically at this time, that so many things in the eyes are showing up. And it's about people not seeing, not clearly being visual.
Not liking what you see in your own life. Eye trouble, meaning you have trouble. Fear of really seeing the self. Inability to see ahead with joy. Dark future. That's cataracts. There's a lot of different things in Louise Hay's book for eyes. Glaucoma is stony unforgiveness. Pressure from long-standing hurts. Overwhelmed by it all. So, got a lot of, basically, what do you not want to see?
Right. And that, like the glaucoma, that's a pretty big issue with a lot of people and an ongoing issue. And again, will continue to get worse unless you figure out where it's coming from. Like what I work with my clients is figuring out what's going on with them and what organ is affected in the body that could be causing more pressure in the eye. When you have eye issues, it's not isolated to your eye. There's another organ that's out of balance that's creating more pressure in the eyes. And it could be one eye or both eye.
And usually that organ is it the
gallbladder? Well, it can be gallbladder, it can be kidney. Often it's kidney. It can be inflammation of one of those organs. And when you have the inflammation, it can cause your eye to blood vessels to bleed. It can cause the retina to be inflamed. It can be cause the macula to start deteriorating. It's chronic inflammation in the body usually that when people start having some other issues with their eyes. So that's why it's really important to figure out if you have an eye issue, where is that really coming from? Instead of constantly treating the eye, like what they do is drops for glaucoma because of the pressure. And what I can do is figure out what's causing that pressure, treat the organ, and then the pressure goes down and they don't have to continue to use the drops in their eye.
Well, that's it. People treat symptoms where you're able to go to the root cause because the body tells you exactly in order what needs to be taken care of first. So I remember when I worked in the office, people would come in with, you know, pages and pages of things that were wrong with them, and they were all symptoms. And by the time they left, they may have had one or two things that needed to be corrected, and it was kind of like they were in shock. It's like, I didn't know it could be that easy. So it can be easy. It doesn't have to be difficult. I remember it wasn't eyes. We were going to do anemia.
Oh, well, anemia too. Well, anemia, when somebody is anemic, it could be...
It's a yes-but attitude, lack of joy, fear of life, and not feeling good enough,
exactly.
According to Louise Hay.
Yeah, exactly. And when people have anemia, that can affect their bones. It can affect their joints. It can affect their
hot flashes. You can have hot flashes.
You can have hot flashes. You can have sensitivity to chemicals. People who are sensitive to chemicals often are anemic, or anything that... any type of fragrances. And when I look at somebody, if they're, you know, when I'm checking someone, I'm looking at their liver and their spleen. If their liver again is anger, spleen is self-esteem. Usually when somebody's anemic, those organs need to be charged up so they produce the blood you need to be healthy. And so it can be a combination of things that are causing, again, you look at the emotions, what's going on in your life, what's, It's like, what's going on with your family? Well, and the more you ask a few questions, it's like, well, I don't talk to my sister. My sister, and when I do talk to her, she's very angry with me, and she just tells me what's wrong. And when my mother passed away, my sister got all the photos, and I have no photos of my mom because of that. So she's angry because that was taken away from her. So the story is, well, you can't do anything about your sister, but you can take care of yourself and let go. Because this is of doing you no service to hold on to this, to the anger and to not feeling good about yourself. And in order to move forward, the more you let go, the more your sister will become better.
Well, and the other thing I have to bring up in that is forgiveness. You have to learn to forgive yourself and forgive the other person. Just by forgiving the other person doesn't mean you condone what was done. But I think if you can find forgiveness in your heart, then you move forward. You go where you need to go.
And that's all part of letting go.
Yeah. So
my favorite words are letting go.
I know. Lately she's like, let go. Let it go. Just let it go.
Well, you know what? If the more aware you are of those words, that when these things creep in, it's about, because once you think you've let go, and this happens to all of us, oh, I've let go of that. That doesn't, I'm done with that. And then all of a sudden, there you are, saying something that puts you back in that same trap.
You didn't let go.
Because you didn't let go. Well, so when those thoughts creep in, just keep saying, let go.
Well, yeah, or you just have to stop yourself and say, well, that's interesting. I am letting go.
Yeah.
You do your I am, because that's the most powerful statement, is I am letting go. I am letting go quickly and easily. Because we had that little thing last night. I had Mary Jane did something with him. She's like, just let it go. I'm thinking, let it go. Let it go. Where's it going? You know, I already let it go. Obviously, I didn't let it go. She goes, just see it going into the abyss. So what I did is I put my little emotional baggage on this magic carpet. And I closed my eyes, and it was like right in front of me. And I'm thinking, she's like, visualize it. Just let it go. Let it go. So eventually, as the evening progressed and I closed my eyes, I could see that magic carpet with all those emotions on it getting further and further away. And then this morning I woke up and I still had my little emotions. And it was almost to the point where they were so far away that I couldn't really see them anymore. So that was my technique for letting it go. Because when somebody says to you, let it go, if you're like me, you're going to, well, how am I supposed to do that? It's a lot easier said than done.
And what I do is, it's like I'm holding their hand, if it's a person, or holding whatever it is, and it's like the wind is blowing and they're floating up in the air and I just let go.
Yeah, or I visualized the threads, golden threads that were attached from me to whatever that emotion, I visualize them disintegrating, just kind of like coming apart and having that other, what I don't need, which does not serve me, just seeing it go away. Cutting the cord and letting it go.
And remember that, you know, this is an ongoing process.
It's ongoing.
It never ends. It never ends. But every time you go through the process and you move to another level, it's different. It's like people say, well, I thought I already did that. Well, you did at a certain level, but there's still some left. So be thankful. Be more joyful that each process you take, each step you take, you are moving into a better, higher vibration. You're moving through your journey. You're getting the lessons. And that's what we're here for, is get the lessons and to become better and work through that so that your journey becomes this exciting, fun,
adventurous.
And joyful.
It doesn't have to be hard to let it go, but you just have to think it's hard getting in practice about recognizing it. Don't give it much time or energy and say, you know what? Yes, that popped in. However, it doesn't serve me. I'm going to let it go and move on. Because the more you think about, how much time do we spend thinking about what we don't want or how things are wrong? I think we spend too much time doing that instead of the positive. Okay, Mary Jane, do you have any final words for today?
Oh, make it fun. You know, just look at what's going on with you and Think about it a little bit different so that you don't have to be stuck. And when you think about it as a game, figure it out. And then you could look at other people, too, and see what's going on and think about how that would affect you. So enjoy life and have fun.
And let it go.
And dream big.
All right. Thanks for listening. We wish you all a very great day. You were listening to the Mary Jane Mack Show on Transformation Talk Radio.